Forensic ballistics. Ballistics is the study of projectiles in motion. The term ballistics is derived from the Latin word ballista, which refers to the crossbow-like device for throwing stones by means of twisted ropes. And in forensic ballistics, the examinations that involve the identification of firearms, the ammunition including the cartridges, fired cartridges, cartridge cases, bullets, then gunpowder, wads, pellets. These are some of the exhibits that are involved in the examination. And it links finally the firearm with the fired cartridge cases and bullets. And of course, the determination of range of fire and angle of fire also are relevant in investigation. Now, if we try to examine the nature of physical evidence vis-a-vis the type of analytical information that can be elicited from the laboratory, starting with the firearms, the type of questions depending upon the nature of the crime that is involved can be like this: whether it is a company made or country made weapon, what is its bore or caliber, and what is the make and model of the weapon, and whether this particular firearm seized comes under the category of prohibited one, and whether it comes under the purview of the Arms Act, and whether the firearm is in working condition, and if it is not in the working condition, what kind of repairs are required for that, and whether the firearm is prone to accidental discharge, and with regard to range, what is the effective range, and whether it is recently fired one or not, what type of gunpowder is used with this type of a firearm, and are there any erased marks. If you notice, whether they can be restored to the original markings, and in examining the ammunition cartridges, the following questions may be relevant: what is its caliber, whether it is company or country made one, and what is the shot size number, whether it is a live cartridge or otherwise, through which weapon they can be fired, whether it is reloaded or not, and then the type of gunpowder that has been used. And with regard to empty cartridge cases, what is the caliber, and from which type of weapon were they fired, and whether the empty cartridge cases were filled one or not, could be some of the questions. And with regard to the bullets, what is its caliber, whether the bullet was fired or not, and whether it was fired from a company made or the country made type of a gun. And with regard to pellets and wads, what is the shot size, and what is the size of the bore, and how many number of cartridges were fired, what is its make, and what kind of gunpowder was used to propel the pellets. And to ascertain whether the empty cases or bullets was fired from firearm seized from the culprit, in case if firearm along with the empty cartridge cases and fired bullets are seized from a particular crime scene. Cloth items, and then the skin pieces containing holes, that is the entry exit wounds. What kind of questions can be asked to the expert? Some of the following questions may be relevant: how many number of firearms were used, how many number of shots were fired, and what is probable range of the firing. Then whether the holes that are present, whether they come under the category of entry or exit, or were they multiple entry by one bullet only. What type of gunpowder was used for firing, whether the rents were caused by the laden projectiles or copper jacketed bullets, etc. Now, postmortem certificates are also relevant. Now, from that, what was the range of fire, what is the angle of fire, whether the wounds were entry or exit, and how many number of shots were fired are also relevant. Now, important precautions one has to keep in mind as guidelines whenever the firearm and firearm related physical evidences are being sent to the laboratory. In case of crime scene involving firearms, all possible evidences such as firearms, empty cartridge cases, live cartridge cases, bullets, pellets, wads, gunpowder, and gun shot residue should be recovered after properly recording and photographing the position of each one of them in the scene. And firearms in loaded condition should never be sent to forensic laboratory. If there is any difficulty in unloading the firearm, the services of the ballistic expert can be utilized. In extreme cases where the firearm has to be sent in loaded condition only, then the safety catch of the firearm should be kept in safe mode, and the constable who carries the case property should be informed about the loaded condition of the firearm, and parcel also there should be a precaution that should be mentioned as to handle this with extreme caution since firearm is loaded in condition. Now the firing pin of the firearm should be protected with cotton before packing the firearm, and empty cartridge cases and bullets should be packed separately in cotton, that means they should be rolled before they are packed. Live cartridges should be packed in a wooden or cardboard box with proper padding so that no harm is done to them in the transit. And bloodstained cloths and wads, if they are found, they need to be again dried in shade, then packed separately, taking due care not to disturb the guns or residue. While recovering bullets which got lodged in the furniture or walls, all precaution should be taken to ensure that the rifling marks on the bullets or any other marks in the process of firing should not be obliterated. And for that, the surrounding or peripheral material should be drilled out so that the bullet gets loosened up and then it falls on its own. So, and with the help of a rubber tipped forceps, they need to be collected.